Henry James. Although Henry James was an American novelist, he actually wrote most of his books while living in London, where he became a naturalized British citizen the year before he died. Born into an intellectual family in 1843, James was named after his father, a prominent social theorist and lecturer. James spent many of his formative years in Europe. There he learned foreign languages and became sensitized to the differences between American and European cultures. This awareness formed the foundation for his later writings, including his forte, the so-called international novel. His productive writing life spanned 51 years. During that time, he wrote 20 novels, 112 short stories, 12 plays, several volumes of travel writing and literary criticism, and a significant body of literary journalism. James dropped out of Harvard Law School in 1864, after only 2 years of study, to pursue a literary career. He first made his name in the realism genre as a writer of short stories, which were published regularly in the Atlantic Monthly. James lived for almost a decade in New England, honing his skills, writing stories, reviews, and articles. He earned a solid reputation as a skilled short story writer. In 1869, he returned to Europe, traveling in France, Italy, Switzerland, and England before settling back in New England in 1871, where he lived for just a year. In 1872, he traveled abroad again, lived in Paris in 1875 and 1876, and finally moved to London in the latter part of 1876. Here he made his home for the rest of his life. James published his first major novel, Roderick Hudson, in 1875. It dealt with an American sculptor living in Italy, who struggled with the conflicting drives of his art and his passions. James would return to this character device of the expatriate American in Europe in many of his novels. His basic theme involved the collision of the young culture of an innocent, high-spirited, and democratic United States with the sophisticated older culture of a wise but corrupt and aristocratic Europe. Daisy Miller, 1878, the story of a young American woman in Rome, brought him international acclaim. His next book, The Europeans, 1878, secured his reputation. In 1881, he published what many consider to be his masterpiece, The Portrait of a Lady. James himself considered this to be his best book, along with The Ambassadors, 1903. The lady mentioned in The Portrait of a Lady is Isabel Archer, a brash, self-assured, but inexperienced young woman from New York who refuses to compromise her American standards for European society. Taken to Europe by her wealthy aunt, Isabel is adamant that she will explore her freedom rather than follow the expected path to marriage. "I don't want to begin life by marrying," she insists. "There are other things a woman can do." Indeed, some have claimed Isabel to be one of the first feminist heroines in English literature. Isabel rejects two suitors, an American who has followed her to Europe, and an English lord, only to accept the marriage proposal of an expatriate American, Gilbert Osmond. The romantic Isabel believes she has found her freedom in Osmond, who is in reality a cruel man. Critics hailed The Portrait of a Lady for its perceptive depiction of American expatriate life and its insight into fundamental aspects of the American character, which James recognized was infused with an insistence on freedom and a desire for power. Indeed, early on Isabel admits, "I'm very fond of my liberty." Later she declares, "I wish to choose my fate." In literate prose, James contrasts English and American societies and highlights the differences in the expectations of the English and the Americans. While Henry James was a successful author during his lifetime, the 1940s and 1950s saw a renewal of interest in his work. His writings were translated into many languages. Toward the end of the 20th century, a reassessment of his work raised his literary standing. He was acclaimed for the subtlety of his novels. Looking back, critics identified in James's portrayals of the interior lives of his characters the seeds of the stream of consciousness literary movement that would blossom in the 20th century.